depths of the afternoon, I saw you sitting there. The light was bright and clear.
I'm a procrastinator.
You were riding Shangri-La, la, la, over and over in the desert sand. Oh, yeah, the signs were golden. Oh, yeah, the path was finally clear at last.
I'm 21 years old, and I feel like I'm just wandering around in life right now, and it's so easy just to sit around and wait for something good to come up. I feel like I have very little sense of direction on what I want to do in my life. Recently, I've been doing a lot of self-reflecting and realizing what happened. In grade school, I was an overachieving kid and everything came easy to me. I kind of just drifted through life doing the bare minimum and still excelling. Now I'm in the back half of my college career with no motivation. Even the things that I like to do, like make YouTube videos, I have trouble doing because I procrastinate so much. I said things like I have no time because of school, but honestly, I could fit more into my schedule if I wanted to. Or I was facing depression because that's every college student's go-to when things don't go exactly how they want it to go. I blame my shortcomings on a mental illness, but in reality, I was just a habitual procrastinator. When I first started YouTube, I told myself I would upload a new video every week, and that didn't happen. So I told myself I would upload some videos after I finished my finals for college, and that also didn't happen. So now I'm looking in the mirror and I'm seeing a dude that is just the king of procrastination, and I'm wondering what went wrong. I used to be this overachieving kid with high hopes and great aspirations, but now I just don't even know what to do. It's so easy to see the future you want to have with the cars, the money, the girls, the fancy house with the giant walk-in closet and a swimming pool, but it's hard to see the work it takes to get to that place. It's so much easier just to sit and wait. Wait for the future to come rather than go out and getting it. I would rather just hang out with friends and scroll through social media, but these things are just instant gratification and not worth much. Why are the hard things always so much more work? Like, what if making money was as easy as scrolling through Twitter? Life would look a lot different. Everyone wants to make money, but no one wants to do the things it takes to make money, and I'm one of those people. It's a lot easier to read about the superstar athlete who grew up in the slums and made his way to the top by just outworking everyone else than actually going out and outworking everybody else. So that's what we do. We just sit and read about it. We have a whole generation of kids who had life easy, so they just sit around and wait for good things to happen to them, and I'm stuck in the middle of this. Being a gifted student was cool until all the gifts started to run out and you actually had to start working for the gifts. It's kind of like Christmas. Christmas was amazing as a kid, right? You got to wake up on Christmas Day and a whole bunch of presents were waiting for you under the tree and you didn't have to do anything for them. Even if you were the worst child on the entire planet, you would never get coal for Christmas. The gifts just came to you and you didn't have to work for them. But as you get older, the gifts start to run out. And not only do they run out, you have to start providing gifts for other people or you're just a bad person. When you get older, you pretty much have to buy your own gifts. Oh, you want the new PS5? Better work 70 hours at a crappy retail job. Oh, you want to have a nice steak dinner? Let's see, is that steak worth the 4 hours it took to earn that much money? But the truth is, the harder you work, the more presents you get for yourself. I think as kids, a lot of us were told good job and that we were better than everyone else way too much instead of look how hard you worked. Let's be real for one sec. If you want to be the top 10% of anything in the world, you could do it. That's just the facts. If I wanted to be in the top 10% of chefs right now, I could do it. I rarely cook and frankly know nothing about cooking, but if I really wanted to, I could. I could outwork everyone else, and the same goes for you. Being the top 10% of anything is pretty impressive, and anyone can do it if you work hard enough. We're not talking about the 0.001% here. We're talking about 10%. I couldn't be in the 0.001% of top basketball players. Like, it doesn't matter how hard I work, how much effort I put in, I could never be as good of a basketball player as LeBron James. I just couldn't. But if I wanted to be in the top 10% of basketball players, I could do it if I grinded enough. I think that's a problem that we have. We always look at the LeBron Jameses of the world and say, man, we can't be like that. And you're probably right, you can't. But you can be better than the other 90% of the world. I think all the gifted kids are looking around and realizing that we're not as gifted as we once thought we were. Gifted kids are kind of just as average as everyone else. So what separates the successful adults from the unsuccessful ones? It's procrastination. I think everyone has the potential to be great, but some people are just so content with being average. Being average is just so easy. I'm partly making this video to motivate you, but I am mostly making this video to motivate myself. I'm making this video to hold myself accountable. I don't want to be just average. This video is to all the other procrastinators out there like me. Get up and go get it, because life just isn't going to give it to you.